Hey everyone, Paul Bowden here from the Office for Mac Engineering team, here with this week's video. Now we're going to talk about Office, Catalina, and you. At this year's Worldwide Developer Conference, Apple unveiled macOS 10.15 Catalina, the new name for macOS. I want to go over in this video what that means to you for IT admins deploying Microsoft Office, how it applies to Office 365, 2019, and the older generation 2016 product. So let's get started. So Catalina is the name for macOS 10.15. Apple announced that there will be developer beta seeds available within June, a public beta in July, and Apple expects final general availability to the public sometime in the fall of 2019. So what impact does 10.15 have on you as the Mac Office IT administrator? First up, our goal is to have full Office compatibility and production level support on the same day that Apple releases the general availability of Catalina sometime in the fall. If you have access to the Catalina beta seeds today, you can go ahead and install Office. You'll need a minimum of 16.26 for either Office 365 or Office 2019. And if you're using the older generation 2016 product, you need a minimum of 16.16.11. You can get all those latest downloads from the macadmins.software website. Of course, I wouldn't recommend running beta seeds for your mission critical systems, but for testing purposes, I think you'll be pleased with the level of compatibility you see today with our existing builds of Office and 10.15 Catalina. As you may know, Apple requires notarization for packages and apps when they're downloaded outside of the App Store. This is something which is fairly new in 10.15 Catalina, and what we're working on streamlining our notarization process with inside our builds, you may see a few error dialogues. However, be rest assured that we're working a way to fix those, and those will be cleaned up long before we reach general availability. If you see any inconsistencies or odd problems when running Office on Catalina, make sure that you send us feedback via the send a smile, the smiley face in Word, Excel, PowerPoint. In Outlook, you can use the contact support option on the menu or the question mark icon to send us a quick piece of feedback. And through your feedback, we can make sure that we can address those issues before Catalina gets released. Last year, we also introduced a change to our macOS support model that will support the current in-market version of macOS and the two previous major releases of macOS. So with the coming of macOS 10.15 Catalina, that means that we will be removing support for macOS 10.12 Sierra once 10.15 gets released. Today we support 10.14 Mojave, 10.13 High Sierra, and 10.12 Sierra. However, in the fall of this year, Apple expects to release the general availability build of 10.15 Catalina. So at that time, it means that we will remove support for 10.12 Sierra. Removing support for older versions of macOS allows us to take advantage of newer, more performant, and more robust APIs. So it's definitely a good thing where we can concentrate our efforts on the leading and the most widely used versions of macOS out there in the world. So what does removal of support for 10.12 mean? Well, if you have an existing 10.12 system and it already has an installation of Microsoft Office, well, that will continue to run, it'll continue to function. However, you will no longer receive updates to the Office applications, and you'll need to at least upgrade to the new minimum OS, which will be 10.13, before you'll see further Office updates. Now, that's true for Office 365 and Office 2019. For the older Office 2016 product, well, that comes from an older code generation using older APIs. And that means that we will continue to support everywhere between macOS 10.10 Yosemite Compatibility through to the new 10.15 macOS Catalina. Now, regardless of which version of Office you're using, we always recommend that you use the latest and greatest major release of macOS. For more information, you can go to akams/n-2. As a reminder, Office 2016 for Mac will continue to get security updates up to the end of life schedule, which is October the 13th, 2020. And after that time, the 2016 product will no longer receive any updates of any kind. For those of you that still have pockets of Office 2011 for Mac, then Catalina really is the turning point, as Catalina will no longer run 32-bit processors. This means that none of the Office 2011 applications will launch on Catalina, so it's definitely time to get those users upgraded to a newer version of Office. So hopefully that helps you with your planning and your future deployments of macOS and Office. I hope this video was informative, and we're really excited here at Microsoft to bring you Office on the latest and greatest addition to the macOS family. If you have any questions, you can find me on the Microsoft Office forum on the MacAdmin Slack. And if you like this video, please remember to click the thumbs up button below and hit the subscribe button to get notifications for new video releases. Take care, and I'll see you next time.